Hi everyone, in this video we're trying to find the concentration of ions when two solutions are mixed. So let's say we have 30 mL of 1.3 molar KNO3 and we're adding it to 20 mL of 2.1 molar K2S, as we can see in this drawing. So two different solutions, two different salts or ionic compound, just so you note, KNO3 and K2S are considered as salts. So salt is another name for ionic compound. So when we're mixing these two, we now want to see how much K plus we have, how much NO3 minus we have, and how much S2 minus we have in here. So there's two methods to do for doing this. So first method is basically to first finding the moles of the salt for each solution. So you first do that. And then second is finding moles of each ion inside that solution. Next step is if the same ion exists in both of them, then you can add the moles up for both. And then eventually you can find the concentration of each ion in the total solution. So that means when 30 plus 20 mils are added up together, now you find the concentration in that. So I'm going to show you all the steps one by one. So again, back to the drawing. So first step, as we said, is to find the number of moles of KNO3 in the first solution. So to do that, we have to multiply the volume by concentration. And this way we find moles of KNO3. We do the same thing for K2S. We multiply the volume in liters times the concentration and then find the moles of K2S. And then second step is to write the dissociation equation, or you can just simply look at the whole formula of KNO3 and find the ratio of ions in there, but it's easier to write the dissociation equation. So, and then do the same thing for K2S. And then we know that for if 0.039 moles of KNO3 exist, because there is one K plus produced and one NO3 minus produced, so their moles will be exactly the same as well based on the mole to mole ratio. And then we do the same thing for K2S. And we see if the K2S moles is 0.042 moles, that means K plus would be twice as more because of the two next to it, meaning because twice as more K plus is being produced and there's only one S2 minus is being produced. So the moles of S2 minus will be 0.042. And then we can find the concentration of each ion. So sometimes the ions are the same in both solutions. So for example, in this case, the first solution in pink and the second solution in green, they both have K plus in them. So to find the concentration of K plus, we have to add up these moles together. So the moles coming from the first solution for K plus is 0.039 moles. And then the moles of K plus in the second solution is 0.084 moles. So we add up these two numbers and then we have to divide it by the total volume, because now imagine these two solutions are mixed. So the total volume is now 50 milliliters or 0.050 liters. And we do the same thing for NO3 minus in the second one, for the second part. And NO3 minus, as you can see, is 0.039 moles, and it's only coming from the first solution. So there's nothing else to add to it. So just that moles divided by the total volume. And then S2 minus is coming from the second solution. So the moles was 0.042 moles. And then again, divide that by the total volume. And this way we find the concentration of each single ion in the final solution. So this was method one. So in this method, we were finding moles of each salt. Then we were finding the moles of the ions in there. And then we were finding the final concentration for them by dividing their moles by the volume. But then there's also a second method for doing this. And this method is using the dilution formula. So first step is to find the new concentration of each solution using dilution formula, because now the reason we have to use dilution formula is because the two volumes are now being added to each other. So now you're ending up with a new volume, so the concentration will change. And I had a video before about this that it was explaining how dilution happens. So I will tag it over here. And if you want to take a look at it, you can always refer to that video. So first step is to use dilution formula to find the new concentration of each salt in there. And then second is to find concentrations of each ion inside those solutions using dissociation equation. And eventually, if you see the same ion, like in this case, it's K plus repeating between both solutions, then you can add the concentrations up. So let's show what we're doing here. So for KNO3 and for K2S, we have to put their initial volume, initial concentration, final volume, and then we want to find the final concentration. So these are the data we have for KNO3. So we started with 1.3 molar. The initial volume was 30 milliliters. But now when you add up the two solutions, the final volume is 50. And same thing goes for K2S. So we put the initial concentration, initial volume, final volume, and now we want to find the final concentration. So we do the rearrangement. And so concentration final would be 1.3 times 30 over 50. So that's technically meaning concentration initial times volume initial divided by volume final. And then we do the same thing for the other one as well. So concentration initial times volume initial divided by volume final. And this way we find the new concentration of KNO3 and the new concentration of K2S. Now, second step is again to do the dissociation equation. Again, you can just look at the ratios inside the formula and see there's one K plus and one NO3 minus, and simply just find the concentrations that way, or you can simply just write the dissociation equation and do it that way. I prefer to show my work by showing the dissociation equation. So you do the same thing for K2S, you show the dissociation equation, and then we will see that if the KNO3 was 0.78 molar to start with, K plus would be the same, and so would be NO3 minus, because they both are 1:1. And K2S would be 0.84 molarity to start with, but K plus would be doubled that, because now we're making twice as more as K compared to K2S, and then S2 minus would be 0.084. And then eventually we can find the concentration of each ion by just adding up the concentrations if there's a repeat in them. In this case, it's going to be K plus. So the K plus was in both solutions. So in the first solution, the concentration was 0.78, and you add it up to the K plus in the second solution, which is 1.68, and that would give us the new concentration of K plus in the final solution. NO3 minus was only coming from the first solution, so we already found the concentration of that, which is 0.78. And then S2 minus was 0.84, because it's just coming from the second solution. And if you compare the numbers for the second method to the first method, you will see we exactly got the same number. So you can choose whichever method you like, and this way you can find the concentration of solutions at the end. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Please subscribe if you want to watch more videos and learn more about chemistry. Have a good day.